now your ABC 7 First Alert weather forecast with meteorologist John Scalzi.
So the temperatures are climbing, and despite the fact that we have a fair amount of cloud cover out there, we're up to 88 degrees already, and there's no reason to think we won't get up into the lower 90s again today, maybe even some mid-90s in inland areas. 61% relative humidity, making it feel pretty sticky in that east wind blowing at 7. Not a terribly strong east wind, but not insignificant either. It's certainly light enough that a sea breeze will form, but it's strong enough that it should keep that sea breeze pretty close to the coastline. By 3 p.m., I think we'll see a temperature of about 93 degrees. It'll be warm. It'll be humid. We'll have a feels-like temperature up over 100. So be sure and stay hydrated if you're going to be out of doors. And by the way, it's a good time to talk about it. Let's not forget our pets. Sometimes those surfaces, those road surfaces, especially dark ones, can get very hot. And we just don't know it because we have shoes on. But the poor pets, they don't have shoes. And so we have to pay attention to that as we walk them on our evening or afternoon strolls. 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms beginning inland and then kind of drifting back to the coastline, where I think they'll become larger storms as they exit out into Gulf waters and dissipate. We'll probably watch that dissipation occur around 7 to 10 o'clock tonight and then leave us with a pretty quiet overnight. Mostly sunny and dry otherwise. Titan radar quiet right now, but you can already see the effects of some of that easterly wind flow over on the other coast, picking up moisture and scooting it back in this direction. Lots of thunderstorm activity in the western Gulf, and it is this section that the hurricane center continues to monitor, but doesn't give it much of a chance for any kind of development. Basically, it's just going to be a rainmaker for that coast, producing as much as 10-inch rainfalls. For us, actually, I think our rain chances will be going down. Under the influence of that high-pressure ridge, drier air will be scooting in here, reducing our rain chances over the next several days. Plus, as that high sinks south, our winds shift more to a westerly direction, and that'll tend to take the focus of showers and push it toward the other coast. So a combination of those factors should yield less rainfall for the rest of the week. North wind switches to the east overnight after we have our little westerly sea breeze in the afternoon. And the forecast looks like this: warm and sticky for several days, lower rain chances, I think, starting as early as tomorrow. First day of summer comes Thursday morning, and it'll feel like it right straight through the rest of the week.